Greetings, everyone, and welcome to another Halloween group viewing. Today we'll be watching Nadia from 1994, which is an independent black and white vampire film executive produced by David Lynch and loosely based on Dracula's Daughter from many moons ago. And it has a notable co-star as the Van Helsing character, which I'll leave as a surprise for you so you can see when he shows up. But I've always liked this one. I actually have it on Laserdisc. And I've always enjoyed it. It's a good indie film. I've seen it a number of times. This is the first time I've watched it in probably about a decade. So I've been looking forward to checking it out again. Alrighty, so as with all group viewings, the way this works is I will give you a countdown to queue up with us. So if you're looking for the movie at the time of this stream, it is available on YouTube. And there will be instructions on the screen on where to find it. So basically, once you've got the movie, if you've got the DVD, or if you're going to watch it on YouTube, or wherever else you find it, basically what you want to do is just queue up to the beginning, and I'll give you a countdown. I'll say 3, 2, 1, play. You want to hit play on play. So it'll be 3, 2, 1, play. And we all hit play together. And if you come in late, or if you lose your spot, or hit pause by accident, or what have you, and need to get re-queued again, there will actually be a counter down at the bottom of the screen there that'll indicate more or less where we are in the movie. So, everybody ready? All right, let's get to it. So here we go. 3, 2, 1, play. One thing I always thought was kind of interesting in this, from a production standpoint, is there used to be this video camera put out by Fisher-Price that used audio cassettes, and it would record black and white silent video on audio cassettes, and they actually used that in this film for the shots of vampire vision. In fact, I think that's what we're seeing here. So it's this kind of pixelated look. All those are filmed with that Fisher-Price camera, which I thought was kind of interesting from a creative standpoint. And the rest, I guess, is just 35mm black and white film. I don't know why the counter is so far behind where I am. I'm going to queue mine up with the counter here. I'm at 145 currently. I don't know how we got so far out of sync. Maybe it just took a moment to load the counter. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. Okay. She just said pathetic. Mm-hmm. Yep. Ah, death of her father, I presume. Oh, I see. Okay, so she sensed that he had been killed. Yeah. For the longest time, I thought her and Scarlett Johansson were one and the same. I got them mixed up all the time, and then I realized I was wrong. Right? Yeah, definitely a resemblance there. Like a young Scarlett Johansson. Hey! Skin slip. Is the Lynch? Oh, yes. Sorry, you're a little ahead of me. I'm right where the counter is, you see on the screen. I think the counter took a bit of time to load. But yes, that is the man himself. That's great. So, for anyone who doesn't recognize him, that's Peter Fonda, famous actor, son of Henry Fonda, as the Van Helsing character in this. That is so cool. I forget what that is. There's like some like chemical that does that, reacts that way to fire. It's trippy. Might be some kind of incense. This is very much the story of Dracula's daughter. I'm so glad that we just recently watched that. The pain of fleeting joy. His demented uncle. So fucking artsy it hurts. It is, but it's not impenetrably artsy, you know what I mean? Like, there's certain artsy films that I just can't get into, but this one I just, you know, it's just kind of the style of it, so I don't mind. It has an interesting story. And I like a lot of the dialogue in it too, actually. Just the conversations that the characters have. Bella, of course. That's cultural misrepresentation. It offends me. Vampire vision. Pictures. Take some pictures for memories. Yay, sparklers. Sparklers are fun. Don't hold on too long. Don't burn your little fingy fingers. The vampire vision, yeah. Fly vision. Yeah. Blood on her fingertips. I'm not high enough to get this. Well, remedy that. Splish splash, I'm taking a bath. Sleep off this silly love thing. Finally home. Oh no. Yeah, I think you're right. Skin slip. That's what it appears to be on the DVD. So, of course, because it's done in 4x3 letterbox, I can't quite crop it correctly so that it preserves the full image area. It'll only do. Yeah, there isn't a 1:6:6 option. Trippy. Yep, that's the one, skin slip. Ooh, Viggo Mortensen. I could see that. That could be interesting. Hi, Andy Serkis as Renfield. I like that idea. Yeah. This tender moment, and it's like he just immediately kills the spider in the middle of it. Ah, interesting. Oh, killed a lot of people, ate a lot of babies. Mm-hmm. Oh, shit. He just needs blood. Lots and lots of blood. In private? Okay, I'll come with you. Can relate. I too am no good in the day, and find solace in shadows. Well then, Do you have a lovely little poem to explain the pain of fleeting joy to him, or no? No, apparently not. It's delicious. With a sweet aftertaste and just a hint of chocolate. Vision. Uh-oh. Now there's trouble when we go to vampire vision. So sneaky. Oh, he does. You don't understand his language? Good. I'll translate. Mwahahaha. Get the fuck out of my chair. I'm a crazy person. I'm very... I need my routine. My chair. The guy who plays Edgar was Moriarty in Sherlock Holmes, A Game of Shadows, the Robert Downey Jr. one. Cool. It's actually been quite a lot of stuff. Whoa, he just like teleported over there. That's pretty rad. Renfield's a dick. It's like, yeah, you don't look very well. You should probably start taking some medicine. And you're still in my chair. I like that. I like how this kind of borrows elements both from Dracula and from Dracula's daughter. It's kind of a mishmash a little bit. And I like Peter Fonda's kind of loopy Van Helsing as well. I think he's a fun character. The fun version of the character. So this Renfield, I gather, isn't full-on vampire yet, but he does have some powers, obviously. Interesting. Damn. Find time for a family reunion. But I am home. I desperately need munchies. I'm just gonna go quickly grab some tortillas. I'll be right back. Oh. Uh-oh. I don't think she's giving you a love squeeze there. Hmm. Was it Edgar? Oh, it is. It's Edgar. Hey, Funk Monk. It's good. Nosferatu shadow. Yeah, I guess it was, eh? Another little nod there. Well, there you go. There's the connection, Worm Disease. You figured it out. The girl in this, her name is actually Galaxy Craze. She didn't do a ton of movies, but she is an author. She actually writes. I love how hippie her name is, Galaxy Craze. Yeah, it's a really good soundtrack, actually. I forgot. Got some great sort of 90s alternative songs on there. As well as a very haunting score. The old cigarette lighting the gas on fire trick. Hey, he's asleep in the piano. Hmm. She got Cassandra. I wonder if she's going to kill Cassandra or if she's going to try to turn her. Some flavor to get to Edgar. No, she's in an airplane, dying for a cigarette. Well, you know, Cassandra seems very nice. Oh, the Twin Towers. I'm in love with Cassandra. I thought I'd just throw that out there. I think that's the standard sound that so many Halloween decorations make, too. I always wear my Mickey Mouse ears when I'm hunting vampires. Renfield's so agreeable. It's like, yep, whatever works for you works for me. I got another big comfy chair here. I'm good. I like how they actually call them psychic faxes. Cassandra. I still don't know. What has she done to Cassandra? Oh. Damn. Damn. She be bald like Nosferatu. You are doing all right there, Edgar? I like how the vampire hunters have a vampire helping them hunt the vampire. Blood is like chewing gum. Oh, what's she doing? Renfield killed himself. Can't stand to be apart from his mistress. Damn. Switcheroo. There you go. Executive produced by David Lynch. But, yeah. Kind of a different take on the Daughter of Dracula storyline. Yeah, I always really like this one, too. It threw me off a little bit when I first saw it. I wasn't expecting something quite so artsy. But it very quickly sucked me in, and I really enjoyed it. So, it was like one long Eternity for Men commercial. Obsession for Men. Hey, the spider was named Sean. Awesome. Well, that was good. I haven't seen this one in a really long time. So it was good to see it again. Actually, I don't think I've actually seen it since buying it on DVD. last time I saw it was on Laserdisc. I still actually have my Laserdisc of it, too. Just one of the ones I kept randomly. Spiders! Spoilers, I'm not to that part yet. Oh. Are you... Oh, wait a minute. Where are you, Worm? Did you just, like, start... whenever? Are you on the ending credits, or are you, like, in the middle of the movie somewhere? Oh, you're a few seconds behind. Oh, okay. Yeah, I think the timing got a little messed up. I don't know what happened. Like, when I started the clock, I started the movie, like, a few seconds after starting the clock. And then I looked, and I saw the clock was, like, 15 seconds behind where I was in the movie. I'm like, what the hell? So I paused it and waited for the timer to catch up to where I was in the movie, and then I continued from there. So it's kind of weird. So, yeah. So anyone who was looking to... Oh, here we go. We got the songs here. So we got, My Bloody Valentine. Yeah. Portishead. Couple by Portishead. And a few others there. Yeah, Portishead was good. I liked a lot of their songs. Kino Link. Very nice, very nice. Yeah, so sadly it's only available on a non-anamorphic DVD. Hasn't had much in the way of home video releases, and seems to be one of those obscure ones that not too many people have heard about, but I've always liked it. Let's see if there's anything on the any extras on it here. Is there even a menu? I don't think there's even a menu. Hold on. No. There actually isn't even a menu on the DVD. It just goes straight into the movie. Huh, interesting. Anyway, yeah. Portishead. I always say Portishead. Like Tortishead. Because, unless it's Portishead, like a porta potty. Honestly, I have no idea. I like some of their songs. But, yeah, hearing their songs is always very 90s to me. Like, very 90s alternative rock kind of thing. I liked a lot of the alternative stuff that came out in the 90s. I think that was sort of the last great era for rock, you know. And then, Auto-Tune happened and killed it all. Oh, well. Trip-hop, yeah. Yeah. Now a lot of the music I listen to, like modern music, is modern music with a retro flavor. You know, like new retro wave and stuff like that. But, or just listen to older songs. That's pretty much it. But yeah, this had a really great soundtrack. I forgot about that. Actually, I was surprised by how much of the movie I had forgotten. Like, I remembered bits and pieces, and like, kind of as I got, oh yeah, yeah, I remember this. But, like, I remembered that he killed the spider, and and that Van Helsing was, you know, very kind of, like, loopy. I really liked Peter Fonda's take on the character there. I was just looking at some of the trivia items here, if anybody's curious. Let's see. You may have noticed the clip of Bela Lugosi in the beginning there. So it says, this is on IMDb, it says, a clip of Bela Lugosi in White Zombie is included to show the face of the father of the vampire family, Count Dracula. In other scenes not showing his face, Peter Fonda actually played the Count, as well as his main role as Van Helsing. Since the movie shares one character, the morgue receptionist portrayed by David Lynch via deleted scenes of Lost Highway, surprisingly that wasn't even filmed for this movie, it was filmed for Lost Highway, it is possible that they're set in the same fictional universe. Actually, I think it was filmed for this movie and then later used in Lost Highway, something like that, which was confirmed by Lynch to be one of TV series Twin Peaks. So, like, Twin Peaks and Lost Highway are in the same universe, and this may be as well because of that character. But I you know, again, that's like one of those very iffy connections that I think is just kind of making too much of a bit of fun. Peter Fonda was apparently cast at the suggestion of Eric Stoltz, who, due to other commitments, was unable to take part in the film. Oh, it was going to be Eric Stoltz. He was probably going to be playing the boyfriend or husband character there. At the time, Stoltz was Bridget Fonda's boyfriend, Bridget, of course, being Peter Fonda's daughter. Very cool. Peter Fonda acted in the film for a SAG minimum and paid for his own airline ticket to be flown to the East Coast to act in the movie. That's pretty awesome of him, actually. An abandoned cancer ward in New York City was the location used for Nadia's Transylvanian castle. Lead actress Alina Lowenson is from Romania, the country where Transylvania is located. And she would appear in another vampire movie 4 years later, Immortality, which now I really want to see. Oh, and if you're wondering what they used for the fake blood, apparently chocolate milk. The beauty of filming in black and white, eh? I think that may be a little Hitchcock nod there, actually, because I think he used chocolate syrup for the blood in Psycho, like to have it going. It swirled nicely when mixed with the water, so to go down the drain. So, yeah, very cool stuff. Alrighty, well, it is quite late. I'm going to head off. So have yourselves a wonderful night, wonderful day, and I'll see you again next time. In whatever form that may take. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you all enjoyed the movie. And we'll see you next time. So until next time, we'll see you next time. So sayonara.